Welcome back, everyone. In this lecture, we're going to very quickly cover what sets are. And sets are unordered collections of unique elements. And this basically means that there can only be one representative of the same object. So you can't have the number 2 in there more than one time, or the letter A in there more than one time. Let's see some examples of how to work with sets in the Jupyter Notebook. To begin, let's create a set. And we can do that by saying my set, or whatever variable name you want, is equal to set, and then open and close parentheses. So right now we have my set, and it's just an empty set, so it returns back set. If we actually want to add an object to the set, I can say my set, and then call the add method, and we can add one object to this. So let's add the number 1. And now if I take a look at my set, I see it has the number 1 there. Now notice it looks like it's a dictionary because of these curly braces, but it's not because it doesn't have key value pairs. It's just unordered collections of any items you want. So let's add in another object here. We'll say my set, add in the number 2, and then if I call my set again, if I call my set, I get 1 and 2 there. Now let's try adding 2 a second time and see what happens. If I call my set, it still just shows 1 and 2. It doesn't show 1, 2, 2. And this is basically what a set is. It has to be unique values in there. If you try to add a value that's already in the set, it won't repeat it. It'll just say, hey, we already have that value in there. I only accept unique values. So when you're working with sets, it may not be super useful to add them in this manner. Instead, what it's really useful for is maybe casting a list to a set that we only get the unique values. So for instance, we'll say my list is equal to, and I'm going to place a bunch of repeated values in here, a bunch of 1s, a bunch of 2s, and a bunch of 3s. I'm going to run this, and then I'm going to cast this as a set, and now I get back only a set of the unique values. Keep in mind, sets don't technically have an order to them. Since we're dealing with very small sets here of just a few items, it looks like they have an order, but in reality, sets don't have any particular order to go in. For now, that's all you need to know about sets. We won't really touch upon this object or data type again until much later in the course. Since we're just beginning, it won't be very useful to us now, but later on we'll be able to see different use cases for it. Again, remember just that sets are unordered collections of unique elements. Thanks, and we'll see you at the next lecture where we discuss Booleans.